What goes with Coach Tangent? No, we'll go with the pink sign. What goes with Coach Tangent? Cosecant. So the derivative of tangent is secant squared. What's the derivative of cotangent? Cosecant squared. Right? Do I really need to prove things in the exact same proof? Different things, right? Okay, let's look at secant. We're gonna prove secant now. Alright, so secant is the same as what? That we know sine and cosine, so what's secant the same as? So we're really finding the derivative 1 over cosine. What rule do we have going on here? It's quotient rule again. Even though the quotient rule is going to look a little crazy this time. Alright, what's quotient rule say? Low D high, what's your low? Cosine x. What's the derivative of the high? 0. What operation do I do? Minus, good. Low D high minus high. What's the derivative of the low? Negative sine x all over the what? Low squared, right? Alright, what is cosine x times 0? 0 goes away, doesn't it? So it's negative 1 times negative sine. Positive sine x over cosine squared x. Alright, I'm going to use my knowledge of trig to break that up, right? We did stuff like this last year. So I want to try to get it to turn into something else, because that's just too much to be able to write that down every time, memorize that to take it through, right? So I'm going to rewrite it as 1 over cosine x times sine x over variable times a variable, what rule am I using? Product rule, good. So product rule says we do what? Name the first, and then what? Derivative of the second, what's the derivative of secant that we just learned? Secant x, tangent x, and then what do I do? What operation? Add, okay, and then it's keep the first root of the second, then keep the second and derivative of the first, derivative of x. One, good. Alright. That's a good answer. But they're gonna do something crazy with it. Okay? This is what you will see them do multiple choice. See the greatest common factor in there? So they will frequently pull out the greatest common factor, and it will look like x plus x tangent x plus 1. Okay, so do you see what's it? Again, perfectly good answer, but multiple choice, it's going to look like this. Alright, I want you to try that one. You should be able to do that one. Derivative of this trick. and cosine squared x all over sine squared x. Okay? So, let's think about this. I do not have to rewrite this to use this property. What's sine squared? Thank you. increasing or decreasing? Increasing, so should my derivative be above the axis or below? Draw something above the axis. Probably not going to have curviness to it. Alright. What about from C to F? What's going on? It's decreasing, so should it be above the axis or below the axis? But I know I've got to get from this point to that point because I'm going to have to curve it up at some point, right? Alright, and then it looks like it's doing something a little bit, starting to increase that way, right? I don't know how much, but it's starting to increase. You can see a little bit of the graph starting to increase. Alright, now we're talking about this one here. I've got to go from this. Now this is acting like the original to its derivative. So it looks like about halfway between. Can we call it 4? Yeah, a horizontal tangent. So that becomes the 0 on the next graph. So, from the left of it, so from what, negative infinity all the way to 4, what's happening with our graph? Decreasing, so should my derivative graph be above the axis or below the axis? Something below the axis, okay? And the shape of my wiggly lines would make more sense here. Then, am I increasing or decreasing? Increasing, so am I above or below? Think about what we are looking at here. When I take the derivative of an x squared, doesn't that become linear? Yeah. Alright, so x squared should look like a line. Alright, let's try this one. Alright, where is my horizontal tangent at? 0, so that's what I plot first, is 0. Alright. Alright, what's going on the left side of the 0? Increasing or decreasing? Decreasing, which means this, should this be above or below? Below. I'm just going to put a minus sign there indicating that I got to go below. Okay, I'm going to do my graph and I'll see what this time. Okay. What about here? Am I increasing or decreasing? Decreasing, so should my graph be above, my derivative be above or below? Below. So I should have something that looks like that. Think about it. Isn't this a cubic function? When I take the derivative, don't I get a square function? Okay. Alright. Where's my horizontal tangent again? There. What should my picture look like if I'm going from a square down to a what? It should be a line of some kind, right? That's not the perfect functions, right? It should be some kind of a line. What's happening first on this graph? Increasing or decreasing? Increasing, so should it be above or below? Above, right? And what's going on the right half of the graph? Increasing or decreasing? Decreasing, so above or below? Below, so above the axis, below the axis. Make it couple of examples to finish. We'll finish those when I see you Thursday. Okay? I did split this homework assignment into two, though. All right, so if there's a couple you can't do, we're going to hold off on questions until I get to the end of this lesson. Okay, but it shouldn't be much. You should be able to do